Hello, hello, happy Friday, everybody. Welcome to my channel, I'm Stephanie. Welcome to my sewing room. It's Friday, that means it's Friday Sews. Now, if this is your first time to Friday Sews, it's a little bit of life, a little bit of chatting, a little free for all, everything goes here on Friday Sews. I am not the only person who does a Friday Sews video. If you just do a hashtag, Friday Sews and today's date, you'll see a whole bunch of people chatting it up, and I love making the rounds. So as soon as this video's over, hit the button and keep going. It's fun. Okay, so today I want to start with sewing and say, have you ever lost your sewjo? You know, your mojo, sewjo? It's just, maybe it's the time of year, it's, you know, changing seasons, I don't know. But I just kind of had that blah feeling, like I needed to push myself to get going. And I started thinking, I have kind of some methods to push myself to get going again. And I wanted to share some of my, what works for me. I do lists, a lot of lists. Lists, that's lispy, it's hard to say list. But I keep lists going of projects I want to work on, and then you know, you can't do them all at the same time. So when you go back to the list, there's a whole bunch of stuff you haven't done. And you're like, I still want to do that. Some stuff never leaves the list. You never get to it. But that's one thing. And then one thing that I do, and I'm going to do a video on this probably really soon because I've been working on this, is I save pictures on my phone of, usually it's like an ad for buying a garment that I would like to make. And recently, this one showed up, this cute top, really cute top. I'm going to show it right here. And I thought, oh my gosh, I'd love to make that. It's funny because as soon as I stopped and started to look at it to see, like, what would I need to do to construct that, the algorithm decided I needed to see more tops like that. And then they just kept showing up. And I saved all of them because so many variations on this one top. And then I saw this one that was different, a little bit different because of the shape of the hem and the ruffle. I don't want that one too. And now that keeps showing up in my algorithm. So I have quite a little, I have so many things in my folder of fashion I like. And so I actually made one of those tops, two of them actually. And I drafted my own pattern. I went through my patterns. I went online and started shopping and I thought, the amount of time I'm spending looking for a pattern to make this top, I could just make this top. So I drafted my own pattern, and I actually really enjoyed doing that. And I hope I can make a video on my process. I don't know. It's kind of messy. It wasn't like I could say, this is how you do it. I just was making it up as I went along. So just to get your sewjo going or your sewing motivation, do you save pictures of things you'd like to make? Another thing that you could do is take pictures, save pictures of things people have made. And I get a lot of my ideas from Instagram. One of my favorite Instagram accounts is Sew Over 50 because they feature women like me, and when the clothes look good on them, they're gonna look good on me, and I love that. Love that. It's one of my favorite accounts. So if you're not following that on Instagram, if you're not on Instagram, you could get a lot of really good ideas from that. And come follow me too, Stephanie.Farrell, I think that's my account. Okay, so that's one of them. Another thing is the Sew Frugal Challenge. My video on the Sew Frugal Challenge is coming up on the 27th. And I've been looking at free patterns and watching some of the Sew Frugal videos. If you haven't already gone to look, it's Sew Frugal 23. And basically it's a challenge that's put on every March. This is our third year or fourth year. Anyways, a bunch of video creators do videos about it, but anybody can join the challenge and anybody can win prizes. And it's put on by two YouTube channels, Yorkshire Girl and So Frugalissima. So go look at their channels and you'll see the whole deal. But they went out and gathered all these prizes. Anybody can join the challenge. You just need to use a free pattern that you found for free and fabric from your stash and post it on March 31st on Instagram and tag it. That's it. So I am motivated to get mine done because I'm doing a video on it on the 27th. So come back and see that. And these couple of videos that are coming out that I'm going to be doing, I just want to say that if you don't want to miss them, if you're not subscribed to my channel, go ahead and hit subscribe. Look for the little bell and click on that because that will set your account to notify you when I put out a new video. Then you'll know when I do the top that was motivated by the Instagram pictures. They turned out so cute. I can't wait to share them. And also it will show you the So Frugal. Totally. I'm going to give you a sneak peek on these tops. I love them so much. So this was the inspiration. And this is the top. This is the inspiration. And this is the top. I can't wait to try them on for you and show you how I made my own pattern. I want to say it was super messy process because I didn't have a plan. And everything that I tried to plan didn't work. So got a top out of it though. So if you want to see how I approached it, I'll be doing a video with all the dirty details of this messy project that turned out good. So sometimes I need to motivate myself with like a purchase. So I want to clean out my closet. Been talking about it forever. And this is a closet that I put together during the whole COVID lockdown time. And I did a video on this closet. This most amazing, beautiful closet. And it's of no use to me right now. It is absolutely not serving my needs because it's full of stuff I don't know. And I can't really get to anything because it's gotten cluttered. It's still pretty to look at because all my containers are so cute. And it's not that I purchased any cute containers for the closet. It's just I had all these containers, pretty boxes and hat boxes, and I didn't know what I was going to do with them. I thought they'd make good storage containers. And I want to label everything so I know what's in there. Some of those boxes are empty, but I want to put stuff in it and then label it, but then I don't want to ruin the box. This is coming to a point. So I purchased something to make me clean out my closet. That's motivation. I just went on Google and I said, I'd like a label that you can remove. And these are removable labels. So it's like a post-it note that you can stick on something and it won't ruin the thing you stuck it to. And I'm thinking it's going to be really cute, like colorful labels saying what's in the container. But if I change what's in the container, pull it off or move it to a different place, put it back. Isn't that cool? So they're called removable labels. I got them online. I think I ordered from Staples and I got small ones and big ones so that I could put them on my containers and see what's in everything and make it all nice and neat. I'm not a nice and neat person, but I am visual. So if I don't know what's in that box, I don't want to pull, like some of them are stacked. Like I don't want to pull down the boxes to see what's in them. And if I'm looking for something and I can't find it, I get frustrated. So I motivated myself with a purchase. Another thing that I feel like I motivated myself to find my motivation is lately I've been going through my fabric to look for fabric for a project. And I noticed that I'm passing over certain pieces every time. And I may never actually use that fabric because maybe it feels itchy. It wasn't the texture I thought I was gonna like, or it didn't turn out to be the color I thought I was ordering. And so it's time to vet my fabrics so that they're all favorites. And guess what? That will make room for new fabric. Because you know, it's nice to have stuff you love. I think what I'll do with the rejected fabric is put it in a separate bin and have it available for muslins, because I'm always looking for the unfavorite fabric to make a garment out of, see how it works. That'll ruin my best fabrics on something that I'm trying out. So those are just some of my ideas for motivation and kind of what I've been working on. Hint, hint, my two tops. I've been just crazily working on them, just having the ball, like a rabbit hole for sure, down a rabbit hole for sure, but I feel like that top is going to be a favorite when I want something. I don't make very much in woven, and I need to get into that a little bit more because there's some beautiful pieces that I want to be able to wear, but I don't have any favorite woven patterns. Now this top will probably end up being a favorite. And anytime I see a woven fabric that I want to wear, I could just say, well, I've got that top I can make it out of. And there's so many variations. You just have to watch the video. I'm gonna show you so many different cute tops that you can make with this look. And hopefully you can figure out how to make this yourself too, the way I did. Just draw it on paper. All I did was draw it on paper. And that's all a pattern is. It's just a drawing on paper. And then you fit it to yourself, right? So that's my little ideas for getting your sewing motivation. And I don't know if that's ever happened to you or you lose your mojo, but sometimes you just have to force yourself to start taking action steps. And then once you do, you're kind of in it and you're loving it and all the ideas start flowing again, right? It's just you need to prime that pump. I thought I would just share that because you know what? Don't we all hit a slump sometimes? Have you ever had a slump and how did you get out of it? Hey, something for the comments. Have you ever had a slump and how did you get out of it? Let's grow this list. I'd just love to see what you guys come up with because you have the best ideas, truly. In fact, I was thinking about a comment when I was making my top. I want to share this comment. Just the idea that you can make your own pattern. This comment popped up. Deb Cobb. Hi, Deb. I just wanted to share it because it was such a good, it was just like everything I was thinking. She says, when my daughter was little, we went shopping for an Easter dress and I found one I liked, but it cost more than I wanted to pay. So I went through the patterns that I had for her and found three that had the features that I had seen in that dress. I took the pieces from all three and made her dress, and it turned out to look almost identical to the one that I wouldn't buy. My mom, who taught me to sew, could cut out a dress without a pattern, and they always fit perfectly. I have used this technique often to get the look that I want. Great job. So she was commenting on my pattern mashup last Sunday, but I take it to mean, you know, if you see it and you want to make it, why not just see, you know, just see what you have to do. And I just looked at that photo and thought, well, it has a dolman sleeve. It has kind of a front and a back, loose and drapey, and a neck, you know, a neck binding. So those were the pieces I cut out, and it really didn't take a whole lot of tweaking because I measured, you know, measured my body, added a little ease, and I'm going to show you in my video how I did that. And I'm still tweaking it. Like, I'm looking at it right now, and I think I want to tweak another little fit, that fit issue. So once you get it just right and you've got this pattern, you can just use over and over. So I guess I digressed. Thank you, Deb, for your comment because that just ached me on. And oh my gosh, so many comments. If you don't read the comments, you're missing a bunch of girlfriends because they're in there and it is a fun free-for-all in there. So let me know what you think. How do you get your sewing motivation going again? Or what are you working on? I always love to see what your projects are. Okay, so on a personal note, thank you for all the happy birthday wishes. I am now 64. It's done. And I didn't have a whole lot going on my birthday like I planned because I had this stupid cough that everybody's had. And I don't like talking about things like that. I like being positive here on my YouTube channel. But dang it. I think, you know, it went through my whole town. My daughter and her whole family have it right now. So we did nothing for my birthday. So hubby gave me some money instead because he couldn't take me shopping. And I'm at the end of it. They're just starting it. So it's going around. And he said, why don't you take, you know, our daughter out for a pedicure? And I thought, no, you know, she can get her own pedicure. That's kind of how I think. And it stuck with me and stuck with me. He can plant a seed like nobody. So I called her, I texted her and said that I wanted her and sis to go out for petties with me for my birthday. And that's what I want to spend my birthday money on. And there'll be some leftover. But it's going to be fun. And I'm ready and I'm looking forward to that. And so that's on the horizon. The last thing I want to talk about is flowers. Oh my gosh, this is just going to be a banner year for my tulips out there. I think that when this video is over, I will go out and film a little bit of where we're at so you can kind of see because it's going to be stellar. So beautiful. We're still having rain. My bestie texted me, I'll be so glad when all this rain is over. She says, I hope this is our last storm. So I text her back and I said, have you ever heard April showers brings May flowers? And she just laughing emojis back because it's still March. No, we're not done with rain. Come on. But yeah, rain brings the flowers. I'm super excited to see what happens. They're already starting to come up around the lower elevations. So I will leave you with a little look at my flower garden that's coming up. And I just want to say thank you so much for stopping by and watching my channel. I hope you're having a great day. I really look forward to seeing you in the comments. And thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye now.